cope. This man I'm tracking down, I'm gonna kill.
Why do you care? It's just another bounty job, isn't it?
Now look, I don't care. I just want to know their names. Who, Cope?
One of them is a man named Randall. Been with the camp almost a year. I didn't know the other two. You want me to ask?
No, I guess not.
You find that son of a bitch, you radio me. Copeland out.
What do we got? You're mine now.
There he is! Silver helmet, red gas tank. That's it.
Oh shit! The hell?
So you thought you'd ride into Copeland's camp, shoot the place up, that about right? Kill a few folks, take some shit, and just ride out like you're just chopping the wall.
Don't let him get away, Deke.
Myself, the one know the truth. Give Drifters a bad name. What if you shot me? You know, who fixed my bike then? Stupid piece of shit.
Screw you! You are a Copeland's toadies! You little bitch! That's what you are! You little bitch!
Cope, it's done. Got him. Mark down these coordinates and send your men out of here.
Is he alive?
Yeah, he's alive. But I won't promise you how long he's gonna stay that way. Deacon out.
You too.
Boozer, you there? I'm just calling a checkup on you.
Yeah, Deke, come here.
Hang in there, buddy. As soon as we get that arm patched up, we're riding north, just like you said.
I hope so. God, I miss you on the road.
Just work on getting better. I still got some work to do on the bike, and we gotta stock up on some gear. But once you're patched up, we're out of here. Deacon out.
Okay, this is it. Yeah, oh, this camp is gonna be crawling.
Nah, you gotta leave the bike out here, Deke, or it'll pull all of them down on you.
Warren here? Yep. How'd you like that? Huh? Come on, you sons of bitches, come on!
Oh, warehouse. Yeah, that looks like the kind of place you want to call home, yeah.
What the hell are you doing in here? This place is a death trap. Getting kind of cold out of here. That'll help you.
Okay. Oh, there's gotta be a nest in this shack. Oh yeah, a nest. Okay, you boys just keep sleeping. Don't pay no attention to me. Come on, boys and girls. Let's do this. Is that the last of them? Loser, it's done. I believe those nests should be less freaks on the mountain from now on.
Hey, Deke, how'd it go? Were there a lot of them?
Yeah, but I wanted to clear them while it was still light out, you know, the sunlight bothers them.
Yeah, that's probably the way to do it. Thanks for doing that, Deke.
Get some shut-eye, Boozer. Deke and out.
the Drifters.
Hey, been seeing you around.
What do you need?
Got a problem.
I got parts, if you're looking. I'll wrap that up for you. Oh, yeah, that's a good piece. Cool. Need anything else? All right.
Me and a couple of guys
Thanks, man.
Burned out in a nest a few weeks back. You know, a freaker nest. Call them. A female can. What do you call them?
That's all I got.
I'll tell you. They call them that for a reason.
Brought hey there. Hey, Deke.
Had to run for our lives.
I heard you were thinking about heading north. Up to Smith Rock or some shit. Yeah, Boozer told me a few days back. Where the hell is he anyways?
Look, I'm just here to turn in some... Yes, yeah, we're gonna be riding north. We just... It's time to move on.
Just listen, man. I'm ready to move on, too, you know? I'm like you. I grew up around here. Yeah, Cope's been good to me, but... A lot of ghosts, you know? Look, you and Boozer head north. Take me with you.
Yeah, a lot of ghosts. Yeah. No. Let me think about it, okay? When we head north, I'll let you know.
Thanks, Deke. You're the best. Oh, okay.
Hey.
See you later.
Damon.
Hey, been seeing you around more.
Manny, what's going on?
Wish I had a better set of tools. Alright.
What do you expect us to fix anything around here?
What do you want? Alright, check back later,
problem.
Man. See ya.
Can I help you? Nice. Anything else I can get for you? I'll fix that gun up for you. Nice and good. Alright. See ya. Deacon.
Just looking.
Hey.
Hey, Manny.
A better set of tools. You don't want to run out of fuel in the ship, that's for sure. Look me up if you need anything else. Thanks, man.
Let me get the gate.
See ya.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Back during the American Revolution, we're fighting for our freedoms. We gained the beautiful right to keep and bear arms. A right we use to protect ourselves, our families, our property. That's
good.
Until the ever-growing federal government got scared of the people they swore to protect. Over the years, they stripped us of every gun right they could, using a few mass shootings as an excuse to curtail the God-given rights of us, American citizens. Gun control. And there went the Second Amendment, ladies and gentlemen. Let me ask you this. When all this shit went down, if every American was packing heat, do you think we'd be in this mess? Hell no. But this is how the feds wanted it. Disarming the public was just the first step toward getting rid of us all. So who did those gun laws really protect? Sure as hell wasn't us, the American taxpayers. Someday, we ever dig out of this? Take a poll. I bet those who survived were those who had guns. For Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Okay, Cope, this time you got me. I'll take all the guns I can get my hands on. Ain't no one taking them away.
Use everything.
Doesn't look too bad. It should work. Another nest zone. I gotta burn this shit down, make it safer. Weeping Angel. This has got to be it. Where'd you hide the stash, Leon?
All right. What have we got?
Maybe in one of these.
Got it.
I just gotta figure out who I'm gonna give this to.
Boozer! Boozerman, are you listening? Wait, you're not gonna believe this. I just saw a goddamn cop!
Chopper! What are you talking about?
A Nero chopper! It just buzzed right over me. It acted like I wasn't even there.
Wait, all this time and a Fed chopper shows up out of nowhere?
Yeah, I'm gonna chase him down and I'm gonna see what the hell they're doing.
Hey, Deke. Be careful. Don't get too close till you know what the hell they're doing. And don't do anything stupid.
Hell no, I'm not gonna do anything stupid.
Rest in peace. They can't get you now.
Whoa, whoa, whoa! Hold on, hold on. They're slowing down. Looks like they're stopping.
After tracking a large moving group, estimated size of 500 to 600, we have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at...
Hey, Doc, I see Site 23 on the roster for tomorrow. Is that us?
No, that's O'Brien.
Got it.
Shit, where was I? We have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at the High Desert Grotto, now designated Site 15. Trampling of grasses and plants at the entrance and the presence of footprints, see attached photos, indicate the site has been used for some time.
Must be nice and cozy in there.
According to the motion sensor planted by Lieutenant O'Brien, approximately 447 subjects have entered the cave this morning. Recommend sending a follow-up team sometime after 1900 hours to assess the cave's interior and further assess conditions. Note to Dr. Anderson. Your theory about the subjects devolving to a primitive state of nocturnal behavior is seeming more appealing all the time. End report.
Not going inside.
Fucking O'Brien.
Didn't you hear me? Over 400 subjects. And these aren't just your regular run-of-the-mill freaks. These are stage 3.
They're sleeping like the babies. And I asked if you were going in. Didn't say I was.
And these subjects are not sleeping. They're hibernating. Ever woken up a hibernating bear?
No.
Ever woken up a hibernating freak?
Yeah, actually. I was one of the survivors at the White King Mine.
Jesus.
Someone tear my buddy apart like it was peeling a banana. These suits protect you from a lot of shit. Not them.
Holy shit, Corporal. Jesus, I'm sorry.
That mission was FUBAR from the start.
Which is why we are not going inside there.
Think if I sealed up this cave, we'd, I don't know, knock down their population.
I don't know, Corporal. A lot of caves out here. Come on, let's get out of here.
Secret caves. is. Yeah, right, like anyone gives a damn.
Man, come back. Hero. Soldier. Kirk Sarah.
What are you?
He had an ID badge. What was the name?
Oh, God. O'Brien. Couldn't shut up about it. All the way out to Three Finger Jack.
He's alive,
Boozer. He's alive.
What are you talking about? We were there. The whole camp was wiped out.
No, I know that, but I heard... Hey, look, I went into their LZ, and they...
Wait, you went into their LZ? What the...
Just listen to me. I heard it over the radio. They were talking about a man named O'Brien.
Deke, don't.
Not, Boozer, I'm not. I'm just... Hey, get some sleep. Deke it out. Are you there?
Yeah, Deke.
I took care of it. Top of me.
Thanks, brother. She'd do the same for us.
Yeah, she would have. Deke out. Go. Good. Watch where I... Still got this. Gotta take a closer look. All right, where? Back on track. Okay.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Broke another goddamn razor this morning. In our supposed global utopia, instead of getting the best products from around the world, we got the shittiest products cheap foreign labor could churn out. Everything in the last 50 years was built to break, so that you could buy once, buy again, buy. You always had to get the new car, the new phone, the new this and that. All to feed the beast of crass commercialism. You want something built to last? Hey, you couldn't go overseas, nope. You need real, hard-working Americans at the helm. When we build something, it'll stand the test of time. And the same hands that built this country, they'll withstand anything this new world throws at us. Our roads bend, friends, but they do not break. And neither do we. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon.
Down you go!
Don't believe the lies.
They look pretty broken to me, Cope, but hey, whatever you say. Nothing wrong with a little crass commercialism. I mean, I could use a new bike right about now. Is it? Goddamn, that's gotta be close. Finished. Should be less freaks around here now. Hey, how many drifters you guys met? Yeah, I can tell by looking.
They got him! Pull back!
Cool.